Hey everyone, blue eyes, tick, 6 feet tall, tick, model actor, tick, heart of gold, tick, humility, tick, tick, that is Mr. Dinesh Mohan for you. Today, we have a story about how he shifted his paradigms, how he found his ikigai, how he stayed inspired and he became the best version of himself. So with 616k followers across all platforms, he set the social media on fire. Where is Mr. Mohan? Let's...
Hello.
Hey, good evening, Mr. Mohan. How are you?
I'm very good. Good evening. Your voice is not much audible. You have
you
to up not? Your volume.
Okay. Can you hear me now?
Slightly better. Slightly better. But I'll manage.
Okay.
You can hear me properly?
Loud and clear. Loud and clear.
Cool. Cool.
If everybody that has joined, can you please confirm if we are both audible? So, welcome to the Paradigm Shift, Mr. Mohan. I think you must have heard what I said about you. You have a heart of gold and you have so much modesty, so much modesty. I remember my first call with you. It wasn't like as if we were talking for the first time. The way you told your story, you were so modest. There's absolutely no airs about you, nothing.
Thanks a lot.
And I think that is an excellent, excellent quality to have. So, should we get straight into it? You have a whole lot of followers. Do you want to say hello?
Yeah, hello everybody. It's so good to see you all. And let's see what's there in store for us tonight.
Absolutely. So, Mr. Mohan, let's start with your early days. So, like, right. What kind of a childhood? Where are you from? What did you do as a child? How were you? Let's listen to all of that.
I have a very mixed background. My forefathers are from Maharashtra, and and they got settled in Punjab. I don't know how many years ago. And I was born and brought up in a place in Haryana, which is called Rohtak. And I did my schooling, most of the schooling there and at another place in Haryana. And then my college also from Haryana. And then I came over to Punjab University, Chandigarh to do my post-graduation. My childhood was just like anybody else. The only different thing is that I belong to middle class parents and both my parents were working and, you know, they would always tell us that we can't give you a lot of property or a business or things like that. We are service class people. So better you guys study and get into a good government job. So that will give you a pension and you will be secure for life. And their entire focus was on that. But it was a very holistic bringing up. Our father would get us a lot of books and magazines and we didn't have the TV and the phone, thank God, and or the internet at that time. But there were books and magazines and, you know, so we would all read and discuss those stories and, you know, Panch Tantra Ki Kahaniya and things like that. So that is how my childhood. But I was always very introvertish and a very, very shy kid and I made very few friends when I was a kid.
Okay. And now there's like a complete 360 degree change?
No, I still make very few friends. I'm still very shy and very introvertish. But the people that I'm close to, with them, I'm very comfortable and very open.
Oh, okay. How nice. That is so nice. So you have mentioned in a whole lot of interviews that you had a major setback at the age of 49. So what was life like before that? And what happened? I mean, we don't want to get into your private space, but what was your life after the setback?
Yeah, correct. You know, see, there's something about depression that it slowly creeps in. And by the time you realize that you are suffering from depression, you are already in the grip of, you know, clinically being depressed. And okay. So that is what happened. It was building up since long. And by the time I hit 44, it had me in its grip. I had some negative circumstances, some personal tragedies. And at the age of 44, I gave up my job and took voluntary retirement and thought of retiring from all kind of active life, you know, because I was so fed up and so suffocated with whatever was life was dishing out to me, so to say. And I moved city. I left the city that I was in and went over to a new city. I thought I would be away from the circumstances and that environment, and that would do me good. But you cannot run away from your past unless you shut your doors totally on it and move on. And which is not possible, which is not easy, you know, to shut the doors on your past and move on is not an easy thing. So very soon after I shifted city, I realized that what all I have lost in life, and I had no financial stability. I didn't have a home of my own. I didn't own a car or a scooter or a bike even. And, you know, on very less pension, which was, you know, way below my salary. And so all these things hit me very hard. There was no friend and, you know, no friend circle, no social activity at all. And, you know, when you are suffocated, this is something that you do to yourself, that you run away from everything. So I would shy away from people and became a recluse slowly over a period of time, and was then shut up in my own home, then in my room, and the weight kept on piling up. I used to eat with vengeance, so to say, and I grew up to almost 137 kgs, which is gargantuan, which is draconian, or, you know, whatever you may call that. I didn't realize at that time that it would lead to further medical complications, and I would be caught in that vicious circle of mental and physical disabilities and ill health and things like that, you know. So just went down into that dark bottomless pit. During that time.
Oh my God. So do you want to tell us about how you had your paradigm shift? Like, what was that day, or what was that moment, or was it over a period of time that you had your paradigm shift and you reclaimed your life?
No, it was over a period of time. It was slowly building up inside me. I was trying to revolt against my circumstances. I was irritated, and irritated with myself that why can't I do it, you know? My major struggle during that time was my inability to walk, because this happened for a period of around 5 to 7 years, that initially I would take assistance to walk. I could not walk without somebody's assistance. And then slowly I totally lost the confidence and my mental ability to order my body to walk, you know. So I was on bed for almost 1 year and wallowing in that condition. But it was building up inside me that I have to change this and be a fighter. And, you know, these are natural human thoughts. Yes. Maybe you are suffering from depression and you have mental ailments, but still from somewhere from inside, everybody wants to fight back, you know. And then one fine day, I guess in 2012, or maybe earlier than that, because at that time I didn't realize that I have to note down everything and I'll be talking about it. So my brother-in-law, you know, he just walked into my room one fine morning and he said, enough is enough. It's either you change yourself or, you know, stop talking to us and, you know, stop bothering us. Yeah, he practically jolted me out of that. In fact, he and my sister, they did it on purpose. You know, they planned it. Like, my sister said, I cannot do this even, I cannot act even, you know, and talk ill about him. And, you know, because she's my sister. But the duty was given to my brother-in-law and he very happily, you know. So, so after he left my room, I thought, come on, here is a gentleman. I'm a very emotional person and I always later on you watch a lot of you hear a lot of stories and you watch movies and things like that, and I'm a filmy guy. So when I watched the movie Baagban, I realized that this guy, my brother-in-law, is the Salman Khan in my life. You know, if you have seen Baagban, so he is an adopted kind of son. And Amitabh Bachchan and usko Hema Malini ji ko, he, you know, gives them shelter in his home. So I thought, here is this guy, gentleman, who is so supportive, and it's been years that they've been supporting me, and here I am, you know, trying to irritate them and not doing what they want me to do. So that was the shift that you are talking about that day. And I practically threw away all my medicines, all my prescriptions, which were heaps and heaps of prescriptions, and started ignoring my illness, you know. I made a mental resolve that, okay, I'll die, I'm ready to die, but I will not die every day due to these illnesses and my phobias and my fears and those circumstances which are already over. You know, people who were who gave me those circumstances were enjoying their lives.
Yeah,
they were doing their jobs and they were going around in society happily. They walked all over me and didn't care. So why would I go on caring and, you know, spoiling my own life? So that is how the shift happened.
Yeah. Wow. So how did you find? अच्छा कुछ लोगों ने बोला है कुछ हिंदी भी बोल दीजिए तो थोड़ा सा हिंदी इंग्लिश में बात करेंगे. So जिस दिन मतलब आपने आपने बोला कि अच्छा आपने पैराडाइम शिफ्ट आपका ले लिया, फिर आपने क्या किया क्या मतलब how did you get to what See, you are
मुझे डॉक्टर्स मेरे और साइकियाट्रिस्ट मेरे जो हैं वो बहुत देर से कह रहे थे कि आप वेट लॉस करो, वेट लॉस करो. सो आपकी बहुत सी मेडिकल एलिमेंट्स और मेंटली आप रिफ्रेश्ड फील करोगे. एंड यू नो एवरीबडी वांट्स के वो अच्छे दिखें, उनकी सेहत अच्छी हो, और ओबेसिटी और मोटापा जो है वो बहुत से लोगों को, मेजोरिटी को पसंद नहीं आता. सो सबसे पहले मैंने डिसाइड किया कि ओके, मैं पहला स्टेप ये लेता हूँ कि मैं अपने मोटापे से छुटकारा पाने की कोशिश करता हूँ. और पर मुझे पता था कि मैं अकेले कर नहीं पाऊंगा ये, बिकॉज बहुत मुश्किल होता है जब आप फूड पे इतने डिपेंडेंट हो, वो आपकी एडिक्शन हो जाती है. एंड फूड एडिक्शन इज अ वेरी वेरी यू नो इट्स ट्रू, आई मीन आई टेक इट एज अ फैक्ट. तो फिर मैं डाइटिशियन को मैंने कंसल्ट किया एंड मेरी सिस्टर भी साथ गई, एंड बहुत होलिस्टिक डाइट एक मेरे लिए लिखा गया. एंड बहुत जल्दी, मतलब मैं हर बार ये बात करता हूँ दैट द रिजल्ट्स वर मिरेकुलस इन माय केस, यू नो, जैसे चमत्कार होता है कि डाइट के दो दिन के बाद ही मेरे अंदर वो असर जो है वो दिखाई देने लग गया. मतलब आई वॉज ऑलमोस्ट ऑन द ब्रिंक, और जब आप उस ब्रिंक से वापस आते हो तो यू नो कि अब आपका जर्नी जो है वो स्टार्ट हो गया है. सो आई कुड रियलाइज कि मेरे अंदर चेंजेस आ रही हैं, बाहर चेंजेस आ रही हैं, और मैं हर हफ्ते जो है वेइंग स्केल पे चढ़ता था और फिर बहुत मैडली डिक्लेयर करता था कि 2 किलो और गया, 3 किलो और गया, 4 किलो और गया. So yeah, within 8-9 months I lost around 45-50 kgs, and I was so happy after that कि चलो एक स्टेप तो हुआ. मगर द टफ पार्ट वॉज दोबारा से चलने को लर्न करना, बिकॉज वो नॉट ओनली फिजिकली मैं भूल गया था मगर मैं मेंटली भी भूल गया था, और अपने माइंड के उस एरिया को एड्रेस नहीं करना चाहता था जहां वो फियर था चलने का. बिकॉज मुझे लगता था मैं चलूंगा, गिरूंगा, हड्डी टूटेगी, मैं फिर से बेड पे लग जाऊंगा. तो मैं चलना ही नहीं चाहता था, आई जस्ट डिडंट वांट टू वॉक. तो मुझे अपने आप को बहुत कन्विंस करना पड़ा, बहुत स्ट्रगल, मतलब मैसिव स्ट्रगल जो मैं एक्सप्लेन नहीं कर सकता वर्ड्स में, कि आप लोग जिस एक्ट को इतना नॉर्मली लेते हो कि उठ के वहां भाग गए, वहां चले गए, एंड टच वुड फॉर दैट, वो मेरे से हो ही नहीं पाता था. इट डिडंट कम टू मी एट ऑल. एंड माय ब्रदर इन लॉ वुड टेक मी टू द मार्केट गाड़ी में बिठा के, एंड जान के ही वुड से, जाओ 2 पैकेट दूध के लेके आओ गाड़ी से उतर के. एंड यू नो वो मेरे लिए इतना बड़ा टास्क होता था. जब मैं दूध लेके वापस आता था तो आई वुड बी जंपिंग के मैं ले आया, मैं गिरा नहीं, मैं ले आया.
वाओ, लाइक अ लिटिल चाइल्ड, ओ माय गॉड.
यस, सो दैट दिस हैपेंड, दिस कंटिन्यूड फॉर एटलीस्ट 2 इयर्स, एंड मेरे को 2014 2014 तक लग गया मुझे थोड़ा सा कॉन्फिडेंटली चलने में, मगर फिर भी कभी कभी अटैक्स हो जाते थे पैनिक के, कि रात को अगर अकेले सैर कर रहा हूं तो सडनली आई वुड फील के अगर यहाँ गिर गया तो भाई फोन भी साथ नहीं है, कोई आसपास नहीं है तो क्या होगा, दैट काइंड ऑफ फीलिंग.
So, when you did this transformation, so how did the transformation become this version of you? Ye story bataiye.
Yeah, I didn't realize that. I'm being very honest here. Everybody would say, aap bahut acche dikh rahe ho. My sister would say, brother-in-law would say, my mom would say, mere brothers, relatives, everybody, jo bhi chota mota family function hota tha. So they would say ke bahut change aa gaya, and I would say kahan aaya, because you know what the thing about fat people is, you know, without being judgmental, wo unka dimag jo hai na wo fat person ki tarah hi sochta rehta hai even if they lose the weight, and this is a psychological fact. Jab aapki sari conditioning ye ho ke ye kapda mujhe aayega ya nahi, ye mujhe khana chahiye ya nahi khana chahiye, iska matlab you stop enjoying eating food when you are obese. तो उस सारी चीज से फाइट करने में भी बहुत टाइम लग गया, कि टू हैव दिस कॉन्फिडेंस दैट आई एम गुड लुकिंग और मैं अब फिट हूं, वो अपने दिमाग में सिंक इन करने में बहुत समय लग जाता है. सो
राइट, ओ माय गॉड, आई कांट इवन इमेजिन टू थिंक, जैसे आप बोल रहे हो, इट्स सच अ स्कैरी प्लेस. आई कैन इमेजिन,
इट इज बिकॉज यू टोटली वॉन्ट टू रन अवे फ्रॉम एवरीथिंग, यू नो. जब मैं मोटा था, पीपल वर फैट शेमिंग मी, of course they do, abhi bhi chalta hai bahut sa shaming mere sath, abhi bhi chalta hai, magar jab maine weight loss kar diya to bhi I would think ki agar koi has raha hai to ye mere motape pe has rahe, matlab the first reaction would always be that, always.
So this
kind of thing, you know.
Abhi kya shaming kar rahe hai, all the comments that I am listening, un log ko very very, sir you're very 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 handsome, matlab wo
itne sare very kind to me, people are very kind hearted, all of them bahut bahut dayalu hain log jo itna support karte hain mujhe.
I know. I'm only reading all the good messages. Like, you're so handsome. I am a big fan. DM sir, namaskar. All sorts of beautiful, beautiful messages.
My total gratitude from my heart. Dil se ehsaan mand hoon main logon ka.
Absolutely, absolutely. So, to bataiye. So, you started, like you said, you had the transformation. To fir kya hua? Like, how did you get the limelight?
Yeah, you know. मुझे ये तब ये भी नहीं समझ आया था कि इट वुड पुट अ बिग डेंट ऑन माय पॉकेट, बिकॉज़ मेरे को एडिक्शन हो गया शॉपिंग का, यू नो, जो एक्टिविटी.
ओह गॉड, ओके.
हाँ, एक वो मूवी भी थी ना, शॉपोलिक समथिंग लाइक
दैट. यस 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 यस,
बस वही वाली हालत हो गई मेरी, बिकॉज मैं 12-15 साल से घर से नहीं निकला था, ड्राइविंग नहीं किया था मैंने, और कपड़े वपड़े तो लिए ही नहीं थे बिल्कुल. तो तब मुझे, बिकॉज माई ओल्ड क्लोथ्स वुड नॉट फिट मी, दे बिकेम टेंट्स जिनके अंदर मैं रह सकता था.
राइट,
उनको मैं अपने गार्डन में लगा के बच्चों के लिए टेंट हाउस बना सकता था अपने. तो आउट ऑफ कंपल्शन आई हैड टू गो टू, यू नो, मॉल्स एंड शॉप्स एंड, यू नो, गो एंड शॉप फॉर क्लोथ्स. एंड कुछ ऐसा, मतलब वो सारा बचपना वापस आया जो मैं एंजॉय नहीं कर पाया था, दैट आई वुड गो एंड शॉप फॉर जीन्स ओनली and t-shirts and active wear and shorts and ganjis and things like that, you know, clothes like three-piece suits and corporate wear would never attract me, never.
Okay,
to main jeans ko bhi phad deta tha, and you know, bahut, matlab maine, mera khayal hai 2-2.5 lakh rupaye ki shopping un dino mein kapdon ki
okay
कर दी होगी. सो मुझे लगता था ये अच्छा वेट लॉस हुआ, मैं अपनी बहन और ब्रदर इन लॉ के इतने पैसे खर्च रहा हूँ और वो बेचारे जेल रहे हैं, बिकॉज आई हैड नो सोर्स ऑफ इनकम इवन देन.
ओके ओके,
सो दैट इज हाउ आई वाज लीडिंग माय लाइफ टिल द मिडिल ऑफ 2014 और एंड ऑफ 2014. दिस इज हाउ आई वाज फुल ऑन फुकरापंथी, यू नो, शॉपिंग एंड मूवीज एंड आधी आधी रात को मैं गाड़ी लेके निकल जाता था, एंड आई हैड लॉन्ग हेयर एट दैट टाइम. I used to color them blonde, and मैं गाड़ी के सारे शीशे नीचे करके एंड बालों को हवा में उड़ाते हुए पूरा स्पीड से I would go. I mean, I was literally flying those days. I didn't want to go back home. I didn't want to go and eat at home. So I tried all the restaurants, I tried all the shops, I watched all the movies, sub late night shows maine dekhe. And I started enjoying my aloneness, you know, appreciating my own company during that time. Yes.
Amazing. So then what happened? Tell us.
Yeah, then, you know, my physiotherapist who was teaching me how to walk again and managing my back pain and things like that, because I had issues like that.
Right.
So this guy suggested me that his father was modeling as a senior age model with some agency in Delhi. And by chance, their front page ad was there in a newspaper. When I went back home, my sister said, "See what I found for you. This is what you can try." So I told her, "Kya bakwas hai ye? Matlab main jo chal nahi pata aur abhi bhi apne aap ko mota hi samajhta hu and all that. Main modeling kaise karunga?" But she insisted ke nahi. Chalo, meri baat mano. Let's create a profile inke web page pe. And agar wo aapko bulayenge to chale jana. Nahi bulayenge to just forget about it. Move on to the next thing. Enjoy, keep on enjoying your life. So, 4-5 photos uske upar upload kar diya, and we promptly forgot that. This happened in June or July 2014. Aur mujhe November ya December mein call aaya us agency ka ke hum shortlist kar rahe the profiles and we saw you and aap hamare yahan audition ke liye aa jaiye kal hi. So face an audition there.
Haan ji.
So I told my brother-in-law ke main to nahi ja raha aur kyunki thand pad rahi hai main subah uth nahi sakta and all that, you know. In Delhi, you know, and I was always I used to procrastinate things all the time. But he said ke main office se off le raha hu, I'll drive you down. That was the other end of Delhi, you know, Pitampura, if you're familiar with Delhi.
Yes.
So I used to live in Gurgaon. So Pitampura is like miles away. But he drove me down there and we went to the agency and, you know, I faced the audition jaise taise dhakke maar ke usne mujhe andar bheja audition ke liye. And, you know, I remember jab main recount karta hun ke my brother-in-law is very camera shy, very, very camera shy. But he said, ke, okay, tumse pehle main audition deke aata hun, because he's also a very good looking man. So he said, ke, main audition deke aata hun so that you gain some confidence. So I said, this guy is ready to face. And he was very well placed in a private company. He had no, you know, koi zarurat nahi thi modeling, acting karne ki.
Correct.
Of course, usko bhi select kar liya unhone. But he, but he never went for any shoot. He said, mujhe nahi jana, jana hi nahi.
right.
So, and I was signed on the spot and by that agency and very soon they started giving me 2016 ke beginning mein. In fact, mere birthday wale din hi my first shoot happened. And
wow.
Yeah, so never looked back. You know, I've seen a movie. I don't know, aapne dekhi hai ya nahi dekhi. How Stella Found Her Groove. If you have heard the name. Stella is a woman who is in her late 40s. And she's a divorcee and a single mother. And she goes to an island with her girl gang to have some fun. And there she falls in love with a young boy who's just 20, 21 years old. And this guy teaches her how to enjoy her life again.
Wow.
You know, so Stella is her name and How Stella Found Her Groove Back is the name of it. It's a super Oscar award winning movie. So Dinesh found his groove back through modeling.
That is so cool. So after that, then there was no looking back. You set Instagram on fire and every other platform on fire. So what all projects did you do? Like once you started modeling, like what all projects, like if you can just show off?
Initially, it was only photographic modeling because I had no idea ke modeling mein kya kya hota hai. पता ही नहीं था, मतलब एक बिल्कुल एलियन, एक बिल्कुल फॉरेन स्पेस था वो मेरे लिए, जिसका मुझे आइडिया ही नहीं था. बट मेरे अंदर से एक अर्ज थी कि ओके, आई वाज अ नेचुरल इन फ्रंट ऑफ द कैमरा, यू नो, दैट वाज देयर. आई वाज रेडी टू चेंज. आई वाज वेरी ऑब्जर्वेंट के लोग कैसे कैमरा को फेस कर रहे हैं, कैमरा एंगल्स क्या है, लाइट किधर लगी हुई है, डायरेक्शंस जो है वो किस तरह से आपने लेनी है फोटोग्राफर की. I was very aware of all those things. So, par fir kisi ne suggest kiya ke aap, why don't you try for TV commercials, you know, jo TV pe commercials aate hain, chote chote and all that. I said, okay, I won't mind. सो एक बाई चांस एक मेकअप कंपनी थी कोई बाहर की, उसकी एक सिस्टर कंसर्न था इंडिया में, मेबिलाइन, इफ यू हैव हर्ड, मेबिलाइन का एक सिस्टर कंसर्न था, मुझे नाम भूल गया उसका. सो उनका एक एड शूट था जिसमें मुझे फादर बनाया एंड द गर्ल इज डूइंग मेकअप एंड यू नो हाउ मेकअप शूट्स आर डन. आई डिड दैट, बट वो रिलीज ही नहीं हुआ, एक साल तक रिलीज नहीं हुआ वो. मगर वहां से आई केम इन टच विद मेनी पीपल हु सजेस्टेड अ लॉट ऑफ कास्टिंग वालास टू मी एंड यू नो. सो वो टीवी कमर्शियल्स का सिलसिला जो है वो शुरू हो गया बहुत तगड़े वाला. आई डिड अ लॉट ऑफ टीवी कमर्शियल्स ड्यूरिंग दैट टाइम. Then somebody suggested कि आप रैंप मॉडलिंग, रैंप वॉक क्यों नहीं करते, because I am above 6 feet tall and you know, and by that time मैंने दाढ़ी वाड़ी और ये सब बढ़ा लिया था, बाल वाल वो सब हो गया था. तो yeah, so FTCI वालों का 2018 में जो शो था दिल्ली में, Amazon Fashion Week, so I was the opening model on the opening day for a designer and yeah. Wow. And it was crazy. I tell you, it is a crazy feeling. The ramp is, you know, Olympic sized wahan pe FDCI walon ka. And there are the you know, the cream of society is there. Delhi ke, Mumbai ke aur shahron ke wahan. Kyunki un dino mein sab kuch full on hota tha. Tab COVID nahi tha, kuch nahi tha. So people were always out and doing these events. And Delhi is crazy, you know, how it picks up models and you know, किस तरह से लोगों को उठा के स्टार्स बनाते हैं दिल्ली की फैशन इंडस्ट्री. सो दैट हैपेंड विद मी एंड फ्रॉम द वेरी फर्स्ट वॉक आई वाज अ सुपर हिट विद डिजाइनर्स एंड आई हैव अ क्रेजी टेम्परामेंट. आई एम वेरी फनी. आई लाइक टू हैव अ यू नो गुड टाइम व्हेन आई एम वॉकिंग और एक्टिंग एंड ऑल दैट. सो पीपल लाइक्ड मी एंड दे स्टार्टेड कॉलिंग मी एंड देन मूवीज का ऑफर आने लग गया. टीवी सीरियल्स किए उन दिनों में मैंने 3-4 एंड फिर मूवीज की. सो दिस इज हाउ इट्स बीन गोइंग ऑन.
Amazing. That is such a beautiful journey. I mean, this is like, there should be a movie made on your story. This is like absolutely, you know, abhi I saw a post of yours, rising from the dust. This is how I rise from the dust. Oh my God. I mean, you know, I could actually feel that, you know, abhi jaise aap mujhe aapki story bata rahe ho, you know, that way you could not walk and you were overweight and mental health problems and stuff like that, and then to turn it around and then oh my
and
God,
these are like my favorite lines. My favorite lines, which I always quote, that you may write me down in history with your bitter twisted lies, you may trod me in the very dirt, but like dust I rise.
Wow.
Yeah, because आप dust में एक quality होती है, आप उसको जितना hard stomp करोगे अपने पैरों से वो उतना ही ऊपर उड़ेगी. So I'm like that dust. मेरे को circumstances ने stomp किया, but I decided to be a storm.
Wow, that is so cool. That is so cool. Yeah. Awesome. Okay, so ये आपने क्या, you know, like you mentioned also to me that spirituality was even before you started your transformation, you had turned to spirituality and meditation. Correct. So एक वो वाला बताइए, because A lot of people, young, old, I have seen that there is a big shift moving towards spirituality. So, us time ke baare mein bataiye.
Ji, without going into very personal details, but when I lost somebody very dear to me and very close, in a very close relationship, I was like kisi bhi aur insaan ki tarah. Mere aage ye sawal aake khade ho gaye ki log jo hain wo mar ke kahan jaate hain. क्या उनका आपसे कोई कनेक्शन रह जाता है, क्या कभी वो किसी अगले जन्म में मिलेंगे, और कुछ लोग जल्दी क्यों चले जाते हैं, कुछ लोग जो है वो देर से क्यों जाते हैं. सो ऑल दोस थॉट्स के हम क्यों पैदा हुए हैं, हमारा पर्पस ऑफ लाइफ क्या है. अब इसको सीखने के दो तरीके हैं, या तो आप चुपचाप कुदरत के हिसाब से चल के इसको सीख लीजिए, अदरवाइज कुदरत आपको झटका देगी और फिर आपको इन सवालों के जवाब ढूंढने पड़ेंगे. सो इन माई केस इट हैपेंड दैट आई वॉज जोल्टेड by nature and I had to find answers of these questions ke jo chala gaya wo kahan gaya, wo kahan hoga, uski state of happiness kya hogi, kya wo mere se abhi bhi connected hai ya nahi hai, aur wo sab cheeze. So I read a lot of books on spirituality and they helped me a lot. स्पेशली स्वामी योगानंद जी की बुक जो है ऑटोबायोग्राफी ऑफ ए योगी, प्लस डॉक्टर ब्रायन वीस की जो पास्ट लाइफ रिग्रेशन के ऊपर बुक्स
हैं। ओह माय गॉड, दैट्स माय फेवरेट।
या आई हैव अ फुल कलेक्शन ऑफ ऑल दोस बुक्स विद मी, स्टिल आई स्टिल हैव। एंड देन आई बिकेम फैसिनेटेड विद हिप्नोथेरेपी, यू नो कि हिप्नोथेरेपी क्या है। सो आई डिड अ कोर्स फ्रॉम कैलिफोर्निया स्कूल ऑफ हिप्नोसिस ऑन हिप्नोथेरेपी which went on for 1 year, and then I became a certified hypnotherapist. So I started my own practice from my home, and bahut clients aate the mere paas aur bahut acha wo mera chal raha tha when this modeling thing happened. And you know, God said ki ab bahut hogi spirituality, live your life, bhago mat abhi zindagi se, sadhu mat bano abhi, insaan reh ke jo hai zindagi ko enjoy karo.
अभी पिक्चर बाकी है, लाइक डोंट गो इनटू द सन्यास।
आई नो व्हाट इज स्पिरिचुअलिटी, आई एम वेरी डीपली स्पिरिचुअल, नॉट रिलीजियस एट ऑल बट वेरी डीपली स्पिरिचुअल। बट मेरा फर्म फेथ है कि जो कर्म मुझे मिला है एज अ मॉडल एंड एक्टर, दिस इज अ कर्मा आई गॉट इन माय किटी, सो मुझे उसको अच्छे से निभाना है, तो वही मेरे लिए सबसे बड़ी पूजा है, तो मुझे और पूजा पाठ करने की कोई जरूरत नहीं है।
Absolutely beautiful. Yeah. So well said, because I wanted to bring this part out because there are a lot of people who feel, you know, jaise bahut confused state of mind mein rehte hain and all that. So jaise Mr. Mohan ne bola that, you know, turn towards meditation, turn towards spirituality, read books, you know, find a guru so that, you know, you can find a purpose in life. Acha, there is a whole lot of questions coming about how you lost your weight, because I am also wanting to know, like my mother says teenagers, okay, she doesn't call senior citizens, her name for this is teenagers. So you know, it becomes like aapne very specifically bola that aapke pair nahi chal rahe the, so your weight was on yours, this without any exercises and this. So if you could inspire people like this, like my own mother who's turning 75 in a month's time.
Wow.
And she is big, she's lost the weight, she's come back again, and she's finding that inspiration. So please tell, you know, all those people who wanted to, this charming desert rose wants to know how you lost your weight, what is your soup and salad, everything.
Yeah, because you know, I very soon I realized that diet is the main thing, not dieting, right. Not dieting, I don't mean dieting, but diet, what you eat,
yeah,
is how you become in life, you know.
Okay,
so okay, exercise and working out is just 20% of your weight loss and fitness regime, and right, 80% is your diet control, your intelligent eating. But people
right,
reverse this, and 80% जो है वो एक्सरसाइज करते हैं और 20% वो डाइट पे फोकस करते हैं, वो जिम ज्वाइन करेंगे एंड दिल से मैंने तो जिम ज्वाइन कर लिया, वहां पे हड्डियां तोड़वाते रहेंगे और घर आके जो है डाइट चेंज करेंगे नहीं अपनी, तो वेट लॉस कभी होएगा ही नहीं, चाहे आप जितनी भी एक्सरसाइज कर लो। सो लकीली आई वॉज कन्विंस्ड कि मुझे डाइट कंट्रोल अपना करना है, अपनी डाइटरी हैबिट्स चेंज करनी है। So, मैंने सारा शुगर्स छोड़ दिया, चाहे वो नेचुरल उसमें थे चाहे आर्टिफिशियल फॉर्म में थे। मैंने सारा फ्राइड फूड जो है, जो मैं मेरा फेवरेट होता था, वो मैंने सारा छोड़ दिया। एंड मैंने व्हाइट फ्लावर जो है, आटा, सफेद आटा, वो खाना बंद कर दिया। इट वॉज मिक्स ग्रेन फ्लावर आई वुड यूज, एंड सैलड्स ऑफकोर्स, चाहे आपको टेस्टी लगे या ना लगे। एंड डबल टोन्ड मिल्क यूज करना शुरू कर दिया। आई गेव अप ऑन बिस्किट्स एंड कोल्ड ड्रिंक्स एंड कैंड जूसेस, जो चीजें मेरी फेवरेट होती थी, चीज केक्स एंड यू नो दीज थिंग्स वर माय फेवरेट, एंड बेसन का हलवा एंड ऑल दैट, यू नो, मैं पूरा पूरा पतीला ऐसे पी जाता था बेसन के हलवे का।
ओह माय गॉड,
सो गेव अप ऑन ऑल दोस थिंग्स। आई यूज्ड टू ईट 5 times a day, but very small portions and very healthy foods, jaise oats khaye banake sirf usko pani mein cook karta tha initially, fir doodh mein cook karne lag gaya, and I would add a lot of dry fruits, but no raisins, kishmish jisko kehte hain, and no kaju, because both these lead to weight, and so a lot of almonds, and walnuts and things like that. Fruits, maybe I gave up on mangoes and chikus and grapes, basically jo zyada sweet the. And bahut holistic diet maine kiya, 5 times khane lag gaya. And in fact, trust me guys, mujhe pata bhi nahi chala ki mera weight loss jo hai wo kaise haste khelte hue ho gaya. It is a fact. I had no hunger pangs. I had no, you know, aise laga ki down feeling hai ya kamzori aa gayi or whatever. Yes, that is true that when you are overweight and you lose weight, your skin sags. You know, there are wrinkles on your face and skin ki halat kharab ho jati hai. And I wanted to go in for surgery for that. But my family convinced me ki aap exercise karo, ab start karo. And toning ho jayegi body ki, to apne aap skin bhi settle down ho jayega. And that is how I started swimming and then consequently joined a gym. And you know, and it actually happened that mera muscles jo bilkul minus the meri body se, wo banne lag gaye and toning hone lag gaya. And here I am. I am not perfect at all. I cannot be perfect. I don't want to be perfect. I am human. I have my flaws. But I wear my flaws like medals because I'm human. Because I'm human. I don't want to be this perfect mannequin, you know?
Right, right. Amazing. That is so well said, Mr. Mohan. Amazing. So I hope you guys have, he's answered all your questions. So go find that perfect diet for you. Look up the internet or probably, you know, Mr. Mohan, you should. Yeah, Mr. Mohan, you should start your weight loss wale pura section.
That's right. That's right. You know, but here I believe in one thing that I don't want to counsel people on anything because I'm qualified nahi hu. You know, somebody jo suffer kar rahe hain aur ek hope se mere paas aa rahe hain, unko main galat salah deke aur zyada mushkil mein nahi dalna chahta. So there are people who are qualified to do this. There are dietitians, there are psychiatrists, there are counselors. So aap unse, meri story se jo inspiration part hai, wo aap le sakte ho. But you know, the diet and wo aap professional se lijiye aur unka follow kijiye. Not mine. I'm not qualified professional.
So sweet. So sweet. So, ये आपका हो गया diet. You talked about exercise. You talked about spirituality. What should we take a little bit about little some rapid fire questions?
Sure.
Because when the minute we put up your ad, there were a whole lot of questions. And then यहाँ पे अगर कुछ questions होंगे तो फिर we will take that up. So let's give me some this. What is your favorite type of exercise?
Cardio. I jump a lot in front of the TV and dance ko sharminda karta hu bahut. The art of dance is totally murdered by me every morning.
That is so good, but that must make you so happy, hai na? Like when you dance,
that is the entire point of whatever you do. Kuch bhi aap karte ho wo aapko khushi nahi de raha to karne ka matlab hi nahi hai fir.
Correct. Absolutely. Absolutely. Okay.
So I'm very much in favor of loud blaring music. Gaadi mein bhi, ghar mein bhi. I'm not one of those uncles jo kahenge, bita volume dheere karo. Kuch sunai nahi de raha. I always say, bita volume up karo, jitna up ja sakta hai.
Oh my goodness, that is so cool. Okay, what are your, you already answered this, but what are your favorite foods that you miss now that you're on a super careful diet?
That I miss now.
Yeah.
My mom's paranthas. That is the only thing. Because she would cook them with a lot of love and a lot of desi ghee. And then usko wo bana ke jo hai na, use wo chur chur parantha kehte the. She would just crush the parantha. And and aap ek khate ho, to wo kehte the, nahi beta, ek aur kha. So,
that is the thing that you're missing, right?
Yes.
Okay. If you had one superpower, what would that be?
That I could, I mean, superpower. That I could see through people. You know, what they are actually thinking and what they are, because this happens to me a lot. I come across a lot of people who are very sweet on your face. And the moment your back is turned, they declare you a zero or a flop or whatever. So I just want to see through people that whether this person is genuine or not.
Right. Yeah. Great superpower. What is the one city that you would love to live your life, rest of your life in?
Paris, I guess. It sounds very cliched, doesn't it?
Okay.
Yeah, but
no, it doesn't. Everybody has their.
बट अभी तो कोविड कोविड में क्या है कि मैं जिस शहर में रह रहा हूँ उसमें भी रह जाऊं तो बहुत अच्छा है.
Actually, okay. What is the one thing you want from the world to disappear?
COVID, of course. COVID, poverty, illiteracy. Poverty. Absolutely. You know, it melts my heart जब मैं बच्चों को सफर करते देखता हूँ poverty से. You know, I went to the market अभी कल परसों. And there was this lady on the roads jo payment pe hai and she's carrying a newly born kid. And that kid was whimpering, you know. So mujhe laga ye kaun jeev hai bechara aur kis halat mein ye paida hua hai. So kuch aisa ho ke garibi aur ye bimari aur ye sab lachari jo hai ye khatam ho jaye duniya se.
Absolutely, so well said. Correct. When are you the happiest?
When the people that I love are happy.
Oh, that is so sweet. That is so sweet. Okay, what is the one story or one person that brought a shift in your life? We already heard about your one person, your brother-in-law. But if there are any more that you would like to mention.
There are stories, yes. In fact, not one. Many stories, but basically, you know, I'm not actually remembering the name of that book, but there was this guy who was jailed a lot, and it's based on a true story. Maybe the name is Papillon. It's an Italian book which is translated in English, and this guy is, you know, he suffers all his life, and in the end he's put in on an island, and how he escapes from that island and creates a new life for himself. That story actually fascinated me. The name is Papillon. Papillon.
Okay.
Papillon means a butterfly in Italian.
Right.
And
right.
It's a beautiful best-selling book.
Beautiful. Okay. Anything else that you want to say? Any other person that brought a shift in your life, or any other story, or something that in your life?
हाँ, मैं बहुत observant हूँ, तो छोटे-छोटे चीजों को note करता रहता हूँ. I'm very sensitive और सारे circumstances को, colors को, sounds को, सबको absorb करता रहता हूँ. तो जो जो भी लोग मुझे लगता है कि अपने circumstances से beyond जाके struggle कर रहे हैं, they all impress me. And बहुत अच्छा लगता है मुझे देख के कि ठीक है, circumstances बदले ना बदले, कम से कम कोशिश तो कर रहे हैं. ऐसे बैठ तो नहीं गए कि हमें करना ही नहीं. And you know, they don't accept their negative circumstances. That is the beauty of it.
Yeah, but I have been noticing a lot of people in the pandemic that they are absolutely not doing anything about their circumstances. So you are a great inspiration that, you know, where you could just move and okay, COVID is different.
I was dancing and making reels when I was suffering from COVID, which happened in April. I had a bout of COVID. My brother-in-law had it I got it after I did a Bombay Mumbai ka shooting kiya tha. So I got it after that. And मैं तो खाते पीते हुए हंसते खेलते हुए reels बना. All my best reels were made during that time because मेरे पास और कोई काम ही नहीं था करने के लिए.
So have you named the series COVID reels or something?
Yes, it started with on the fourth day with my eating custard and dancing.
Okay. I'm going to go and watch those.
Yes. But of course I look very pale in them because COVID is a very serious illness. But you have to keep yourself entertained, you know, to fight back.
Yeah. You're right. Absolutely. Okay. When are you the happiest? Did we answer that question already? Yes, you have.
I did.
What is the one thing you still want to achieve? You achieved so much, but is there something?
Yeah. Again, you know, good health for me and my family.
Wow. Beautiful. Yeah. That is so beautiful. What is the one advice that you will give to all the unkind people on the internet, which there is a whole lot of them on the social media? So if you have one.
Yeah, you know, if COVID, something like COVID cannot teach you to be kind, then only God can help you. लोग मर रहे हैं, बीमार हैं, और इधर कुछ लोग हैं जो सिर्फ बकवास कर रहे हैं आपके बारे में और लोगों के बारे में जिनको वो जानते भी नहीं. तो बड़ा अजीब लगता है कि ये हालात में तो रियलाइज करो कि लाइफ कितना ब्यूटीफुल और प्रेशियस है, लोग जो हैं वो कितने ब्यूटीफुल और प्रेशियस हैं जो कुछ भी करने की कोशिश कर रहा है. और मुझे तो मेरे एज को लेके बहुत शेम करते हैं लोग. दे कॉल मी बुड्ढा, दे कॉल मी दिस, दे कॉल मी वट एवर कम्स टू देयर माइंड एज रिलेटेड, दे कॉल मी एंड इट्स ओके. आई एम नॉट रनिंग अवे फ्रॉम, आई एम एम्ब्रेसिंग माय एज. या मैं परफेक्टली खुश हूँ. एंड आई डोंट लाइक कॉम्प्लीमेंट्स जिसमें लोग कहें कि आप तो 50 से ऊपर लगते ही नहीं हो. आई वुड रादर लाइक दे वुड से आप तो 80 के लगते हो, तो मैं 80 तक जीऊंगा तो उनकी बात सच निकलेगी.
Oh my God! So, when people say this, how do you this, or you just ignore such people?
I used to be very irritated initially. अभी भी हो जाता हूँ जब मैं खराब मूड में होता हूँ. कोई बहुत गलत बात कहता है तो मैं उसको फनी तरीके में जवाब देने की कोशिश करता हूँ. But generally I ignore, which is a better way to deal with it. Because आप अपने दिल पे क्यों लोगे? उन लोगों को पता भी नहीं है कि आप कौन हो, क्या हो, आपका स्ट्रगल क्या है, स्टोरी क्या है, और हर किसी का. बट उनके पास वेलापंथी है कि उन्होंने कुछ ना कुछ बोलना है. तो बट जो लोग एज शेम करते हैं मुझे, गॉड हेल्प देयर पेरेंट्स, बिकॉज पेरेंट्स किसी के भी जवान नहीं होते.
करेक्ट.
तो घर में माँ बाप की क्या हालत करते होंगे कि वो बूढ़े हैं, मैं तो उनको जानता भी नहीं और मेरे बारे में इतना बोल रहे हैं. वो तो दिन रात उनके साथ हैं.
Right, absolutely. One thing that you would want to, you know, you did a beautiful ad on adult diapers, which I thought was so good, because you'll not believe that even my in-laws, they're like, my father-in-law, we lost him last December, 94 and all. At that age also, he would be like, no, I cannot wear a diaper. So what you brought out was so beautiful, that this is not a stigma, this is not something to be ashamed of. So it's hats off to you that you had the courage of doing something like that. Would you like to say something?
You know, this same thing happened when I started talking about my depression. You know, nobody would talk about that. जब मैंने सबसे पहले इस बारे में बात की तो कोई लोग बात करते नहीं थे. स्पेशली शोबिज में लोग बात नहीं करते थे. उनको लगता था कि लोग कहेंगे कि तो कभी भी इसको दौरा पड़ जाएगा और इसको काम नहीं देना, एंड ये तो कब बीमार पड़ जाए, मेंटली कब सिक हो जाए, क्योंकि ये तो पागल है. बट मैंने खुल के बात किया, बिकॉज मुझे लगा कि लोगों की हेल्प हो सकती है, तो व्हाई नॉट. या व्हाट इज माय करियर इन फ्रंट ऑफ पीपल्स हेल्थ,
राइट?
सो सिमिलरली जब मुझे इन लोगों ने अप्रोच किया, फ्रेंड्स एडल्ट डायपर वालों ने, तो मुझे एक मिनट के लिए लगा कि दिस इज सच अ टॉपिक कि इसमें मजाक भी बहुत उड़ सकता है, लोग उड़ा सकते हैं और कुछ भी बोल. बट देन अगेन मुझे लगा कि यार देर आर मिलियंस ऑफ पीपल हु आर सफरिंग, एंड यू नो वो बताते भी नहीं है, बताते भी नहीं, अपने बच्चों को भी नहीं बताते. वो जल्दी से बेचारे सुबह उठ के अपने बेड को सारा ऐसे मैनेज कर देते हैं कि किसी को पता ना लगे कि उनके साथ क्या हुआ रात को. सो व्हाई अंडरगो सो मच ऑफ बॉदरेशन, जस्ट गो एंड बाय डायपर्स, पुट देम ऑन एंड स्लीप वेल, आराम से सोओ एंड चैन की नींद. बिकॉज आई हैव पास थ्रू दिस स्टेज, नॉट टू दैट एक्सटेंट, बट यू नो द इनिशियल स्टेजेस ऑफ. So I don't shy away from talking about things which are health related, because they always help somebody. Sabka nahi to kisi ka to madad ho hi raha.
Absolutely.
So that is the thing.
And I want you to this is beautiful, and I want you to address all the teenagers, like my mom says, all the teenagers who are, you know, sitting in one corner of the house and, you know, not being able to find their inspiration, or wo you know apne hi andar gut gut ke. Acha, also one thing I've noticed, you know, like hugging is oxytocin, so I want you to tell everybody to hug their teenagers at home, so that at least wo hug se wo oxytocin unme paida ho, that will make them happy. So
correct,
that is
like, and I am again very fortunate in this, very very fortunate, because when I was trying to come out of depression, my sister and brother-in-law had made it a routine to come and hug me on every on the drop of a hat. They would come to my room एंड यू नो ऑफिस जाते हुए ऑफिस से आते हुए गुड मॉर्निंग करते हुए गुड नाइट करते हुए एंड एट टाइम्स माय मॉम वुड से बिकॉज मेरी फैमिली में ये सब नहीं था माय पेरेंट्स वुड नेवर डू दैट माय ब्रदर्स वुड नेवर डू दैट एंड माय मॉम वुड से व्हाट इज दिस यार के ये जब ये लोग रोटी खाने लगते हैं तो ये पहला निवाला जो है तुम्हें देते हैं एंड जब भी इनको मौका मिलता है ये आके तुम्हें हग कर लेते हैं तो आई सेड आई एम वेरी लकी एंड दिस कंटिन्यूज टिल डेट नाउ माय भांजा इज देयर ओजस एंड वो तो फुल ऑन फिजिकल है फुल ऑन फिजिकल वो तो मतलब ही इज कांस्टेंटली हगिंग अस एंड यू नो एंड ही इज अ किड सो वेरी फॉर्चूनेटली बट राइटली सेड दिस इज अ नेगेटिविटी दैट यू डोंट इवन हैव टू स्पीक दैट आई लव यू और आई केयर फॉर यू जस्ट गो एंड गिव योर पीपल अ वार्म tight hug and you know wo sare jitna dimag mein negativity chal rahi hoti hai wo sab dhul jati hai usse
correct absolutely wo jo munna bhai ki jadoo ki jhappi hai that is actually chemically proven that it will create oxytocin
yes so please it does
absolutely yeah. absolutely this is so well said so ek aap mujhe to all our teenagers, I will not say senior citizens, seniors, आप उनको क्या एक मैसेज देना चाहें?
I mean, I'm not in a position to advise anybody. I can only suggest, you know, like a friend, like a buddy. And everybody knows this that life कितनी temporary है. इस age तक तो पता लग ही जाता है कि बहुत temporary right. है. आपने इतने लोगों को आते जाते हुए देखा है. And you've all been so strong कि आप उन सारे हालात से निकल गए तो आप खुद से मत हारिए जो आपका अपना thought process है उससे मत हारिए because आपको बाहर के circumstances नहीं हरा सके so मन के हारे हार है मन के जीते जीत so win over yourself and start loving yourself passionately खुद को पहले रख के हर situation में हर relation में हर जगह पे खुद को पहले रखना सीखिए बिकॉज आपने ही आपके साथ आखिरी सांस तक रहना एंड दिस इज व्हाट आई डू आई लव माई सेल्फ सो पैशनेटली कि जिन जो लोग मेरे से बहुत अटैच्ड भी हैं जैसे मेरी सिस्टर और ब्रदर इन लॉ भी आई डोंट लेट एनीबडी हार्म माई इमोशनल थॉट प्रोसेस आई जस्ट मैं बहुत पोलाइटली बोल देता हूँ कि अभी मेरा मूड नहीं है अभी मेरा मन नहीं है प्लीज डोंट डिस्टर्ब मी क्योंकि मैं खुद से बहुत प्यार करता हूँ एंड आई डोंट वॉन्ट टू डिस्टर्ब माई सेल्फ एंड ऐसे ही होना चाहिए सबको बी सेल्फिश अबाउट योरसेल्फ अटरली सेल्फिश
ब्यूटिफुल दैट इज सो वेल सेड सो बिफोर वी एंड दिस लाइव आई जस्ट वॉन्ट टू टेल एवरीबडी दैट इज ज्वाइनिंग अस फ्रॉम मिस्टर दिनेश मोहन साइड प्लीज फॉलो द पैराडाइम शिफ्ट पेज बिकॉज वी ब्रिंग यू ब्यूटिफुल इंस्पिरेशनल स्टोरीज लाइक मिस्टर दिनेश मोहन जो अपने लिए जो सोसाइटी के लिए इतने बड़े इंस्पिरेशन है इतने बड़े मोटिवेशन है एंड जस्ट बाय हिज ओन ट्रांसफॉर्मेशन ही हैज गॉन एंड इंस्पायर्ड मिलियंस लाइक वो मुझे उस दिन फोन पे बता रहे थे दैट आफ्टर हिम देयर आर सो मेनी पीपल अच्छा दिनेश यू नो मिस्टर मोहन हमारे माई फ्रेंड्स ऑल्सो लाइक वी आर इन दैट एज ना 50 एंड दिस हम लोग के भी सब लोग प्लीज हम लोग को भी मॉडल बना दीजिए वी वॉन्ट कलर दैट नाउ आई वाज लाइक यस यस आई विल पुट योर मैसेज अक्रॉस ओके सो गेटिंग बैक टू दिस सो प्लीज फॉलो आवर पेज एंड एवरीबडी दैट इज फॉलोइंग द पैराडाइम शिफ्ट पेज we have been tagging mr mohan's stories and this he puts up lovely posts he puts up beautiful reels and so inspirational and so inspiring so please follow him for your daily dose of motivation
thank you so much
now would you like to say something to our people
I mean yes why not I love everybody I'm a total people's person halanki main sabke sath abhi bhi khul nahi pata hu but I'm a total right. people's person I love all the people who are following me or those who don't even follow me and log hain to hum sab hain aur ye connections hain to zindagi hai so god bless everybody for being so kind to me I cannot return all your love But I will try till my last breath के मैं जो कर पाता हूँ सबके लिए वो मैं करता रहूँ
Beautiful. That is so well said. So a big shout out to your family because they have been a great support. Jaise aapne bola ki Dr. Brian Weiss ke books aapne padhe hain. I'm sure you were their baby in the last janam, that they're still treating you like a baby. Niwala khila rahe hain, kissi kar rahe hain.
I won't mind aane wale janmon mein bhi unka baby banna.
That is so beautiful. That is so beautiful. So thank you so much, Mr. Mohan, for doing this for us, coming on our platform and giving us your valuable time. And what you've done today is invaluable. Thank you so much.
Thank you so much for having me. And God bless you and God bless everybody. So I take your leave now. Good night and bye-bye. Take care.
Thank you. Bye-bye. Have a great weekend.
You too. Bye-bye. Bye-bye.